PPPs can be used for projects to improve resilience to climate change events and adapt to the long-term effects of climate change, because they can accelerate delivery through procurement streamlining, single-source responsibility, and private innovations. Additionally, PPPs can provide necessary integrated program management for the project, and climate actions will require significant capital investments in projects that provide long-term solutions and a commitment for guaranteed operations and maintenance. The project company can structure and offer private investment and project financing, as well as life cycle asset management. Finally, the impacts of climate change require innovative and flexible solutions, which PPPs promote. An example of a climate action PPP is infrastructure for a major coastal port city, which is at risk of severe flooding. Coastal cities are prone to a variety of climate risks, including sea level rise, storm surge, greater storm intensity, land subsidence, and increased overall precipitation, which requires significant infrastructure investments. Some of the considerations unique for developing and implementing climate resilience PPPs include the following. Technical. For climate resilience projects, you need to address what is likely to happen in the future. Traditionally, designers looked at historical storm data to design projects, but climate PPPs need to predict the future using the best available science and modeling to create a universal baseline. Funding and financing. Climate PPPs generally don't generate income. Therefore, governments must identify sustainable funding and financing sources to support the project. For example, a value assessment could be assigned based on a benefit-cost analysis of various infrastructure improvements and its likelihood to prevent future damage and potential negative impacts to the local economy. Legal and regulatory. Sufficient policy, legal, and regulatory frameworks should be in place to make sure there are no roadblocks during procurement and implementation. For example, if a flood control effort requires the relocation of populations and the taking of land in a flood zone, the government needs the power to take this action. Environmental and social. Most international grants, loans, and financing must be used for specific purposes and have guidelines for addressing environmental and social issues in order to obtain those institutions' participation. An analysis should assess the risk associated with environmental and social issues, as well as the benefits. Commercial structuring. The PPP commercial structuring and delivery model should carefully define force majeure events, how much control the public sector maintains, and how much unknown risk the private sector will assume. Risk fluctuations due to climate change over the course of the project should also be anticipated in the agreements. Not every climate resilience project is appropriate for a PPP. But with careful suitability analysis, PPPs are a potential tool to help resolve the impacts of climate change. Learn more at our PPP website, www.cldp.doc.gov/PPP.